In this video, we're going to look at how we can make our notes more useful. Well, what do I mean by that? Well, in addition to just adding text to a note, what we're also able to do is format that text. We can make it bold. We can italicize it. We can add checklists. We can add tables. We can even add images and scan into a note. That's what we'll be exploring in this video, how we can make our notes more useful. Now, before we get started, if you like what you see here, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at how we can make our notes more useful on the iPhone. Let's go over to my iPhone. Let's first take a look at how we can format the text, like make it bold or italic, or even change the text style, such as the heading. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a look at this note here, camera tip. I tap on it. And as of right now, this is just a basic note. We have our title up at the top, and then we have our body text down here. Now, what I want to do is I want to make some of this text bold. How do I do that? Well, the first thing that we need to do is we need to select the text. So how do you select text? You just double tap on it. So we have this word here, select. I want to make that bold. So what I do is I just double tap on the word select, and when I do, you're going to see that it is now selected. And then from here, what I do is I just go down to the double A's here. And when I tap on that, you're going to see I have the option to make it bold, italic, underline it, or add a strike through. So we're just going to go with bold. I tap on the B. And now, when I tap on done, you're going to see that the word select is now bold. Let's go and make something italic. What we're going to do is we're going to make this last sentence here italic. So I need to select that last sentence. So now I just double tap on any one of the words in that sentence. So I'm going to double tap on the word iPhone. And then I take these handles here and I drag them to select the sentence. So I'm going to drag the handle on the end. And now I take the one at the beginning. I have that whole sentence there selected. Now what I do is I go back over my formatting here, and I just select italic. And now we can see that that is italicized. So that's how we can easily format it. We can also add bullet points. So what I would like to do is add some bullet points in here. All we need to do is just start typing, and wherever we want to have a bullet point, we have to hit a return key. So we just make a list. Let's just call it a list for right now. So open camera. Pretty simple tip there, right? I hit return. This is going to be the next bullet. Now click on shutter. And we'll go with one more. Review photo. So now what I'd like to do is have this be a bullet point. Just select it, double tap on one word, and I just go and drag it to select everything there. And then we go back over here to our double A's, and when I do, I'm going to have the option to make it a bullet. I can make it ordered or unordered. So we're just going to go with a simple bullet list. We're going to go with the first one, and if we look, we can see that that is now bulleted. It is still italic. I don't want to have it italic anymore, so I just double tap on one word. And we select. We go to the double A. And now that is no longer italic. And it is bulleted. If I put my cursor at the end here and hit return, what it's going to do is it's going to add another bullet. So now I can just continue creating my list. When I'm done, I hit return again, and it removes the bullet. So that's how we can easily create bullet points. And if we want to change it, again, we just select it. If I want to change this into an ordered list with numbers, I just go back over to my list here. And now we can see it is numbers. So that's how we can create bullet points. Now, what about checklists? Maybe I want to have this be a checklist. How can I do that? Well, basically, I just have to select it. So again, I just double tap on one of the words, and then we select it. So I have it selected. And now what we do is we go over here to the checklist. And when I tap on that, what it's going to do is it's going to turn this into a checklist. So now it is no longer bullets. I can tap on those circles to check them off. And then I tap on them to uncheck them. Now, if you want to do this from scratch, you can do that as well. And this works with bullets as well as checklists. So when I put my return in there, if I just go and tap on the checklist here, what it's going to do is it's going to create that checklist and I can start typing. So I don't have to do any selection. So if you know what you want to have bulleted or what you want to have in a checklist, you can just go into the proper tool here, tell it what you want it to do, and then start typing. And then from there, what it's going to do is it's going to create that checklist or that bullet. So I'm just going to delete that. So that's how we can create checklists. Now, another thing we can do is we can add basic tables. Don't get me wrong, this is not anything like numbers or Excel, but we can insert a basic table. To do that, what we do is we just place our cursor where we want it, and then we tap on this here. This is our table tool, and when I do, we have my table. I can select the column just by tapping on the ellipsis here, and then of course, I can also select the row by tapping on the ellipsis there, and I have that row selected. I want to add another row. Two ways I can do this. I can tap on the ellipsis here, and when I do, I have the option to delete or add a row. Or what I could do is I could just place my cursor in here, and when I do, if I hit next, what it's going to do is it's going to add another row. Same thing with columns. All I have to do is just tap on the ellipsis here to select it, and then I tap on it again, and I can go and delete a column or add a column. So that's how we can work with tables. Very basic, but at least we can add a table in there. Now, if you want to add an image in there, you can do that as well. All we have to do is just place our cursor in there, and then you're going to see the little paperclip here. This is an attachment. And actually, we have a few different options with attachments. I tap on it. I can go and attach a file. I can record audio, so I can record my voice in there. I can also choose an image from Image Playground if you have Apple Intelligence. But probably more important, what more people will use, is choose a photo or video from your photos library. You can take a photo or video, and you can even scan a document. And then if you want to scan text from a document, you can do that as well. It's not going to scan the document. What it's going to do is it's going to scan the text in that document. So we have a lot of options with our attachments. And then once we take the photo or scan the document, what it'll do is it'll place it in our note here. Pretty simple. Now, another thing we can do is we can draw on a note. How do we do that? Well, basically, we just place the cursor where we want to start drawing. When we draw, basically what it's going to do is it's going to divide the note in half. Everything above it is going to be our text, our photos, anything like that. Everything below it is going to be our drawing. So when I go and place my cursor in here, and I go and tap on the drawing tool, that's basically what that tool is, what it's going to do is it's going to put a line in here, and I draw everything below it. So I'm going to tap on it. And all I do is just start drawing here, and we can see that I'm drawing on there. I have a number of different tools, and if we look, there's that line. So everything above that is going to be my text, my photos, anything like that. Everything below it is going to be my drawing. And again, we do have a number of different tools here to help us draw. I am not an artist, so you don't want to see me draw anything there. But that's basically all we have to do. What about links? We can also add links to our notes. So how do we do that? Well, basically, we have two different ways to do that, or I should say two different options for links. We can link to a website, or we can link to another note. So how do we create these links? Well, basically, you just tap in there, and then you start typing. So I'm just going to call this link here. And all I need to do is just select that text. So I double tap on it. It is selected. And then we go over here to this bar, and when we tap on the right caret, that's that arrow on the right, you're going to see the option, I keep tapping on it, you're going to see the option eventually to add a link. And when I tap on that, it's going to give me the option to add a link to that text that I called link. If I wanted to rename it, I could easily rename it. So how do I create a link? Well, right down here is where I enter in the URL. So if I copied something from Safari, I could paste that URL in there, and then that link, that word, will open that website up in Safari. If I want to link to another note, I can do that as well. All I have to do is just start typing. I know I have a note called Tulip Time, so I'm just going to go in here and start typing Tulip Time, and now it's going to link to that note. I tap on that, and then I tap on Done. And now, when I tap on this text here, let's go ahead and do that. It's going to take me over to my Tulip Time note. I want to link back over there. All I have to do is just start editing this note. I'm just going to call this Tips. I double tap on it. We go to the arrow. I go to Add Link. And this is Camera Tips. And now when I tap on Tips here, watch what happens. It takes me back over to that other note. So we can easily create links to other notes or to websites. If you want to create a note with a website, I'm going to show you a shortcut, an easier way to do it. Do it from within Safari. So I'm going to go to Safari here. And let's say I wanted to create a link to this website. How can I do that? Well, one way is to copy this URL here and then paste it into a note and create that link. Kind of a long way of doing it. Isn't there an easier way? There is. All you have to do is just share this website to a note. So let's do that. So I'm going to go to Tulip Time here. We go over here to the share icon. And when I tap on that, what I'm able to do is share it to my notes. If you don't see notes here, what you might have to do is just go and scroll over. But somewhere in here, you're going to see your notes app. I tap on that. And now what I'm able to do is save it to a new note. If I wanted to create a new note, I could do that. But I want to save this to my camera tips note. How can I do that? Well, I tap on that. And then I go over to notes. There's my camera tip. I tap on that. Now it's going to add this website over to that note. And if I wanted to add text to it, I could do that too. I could add text here. So I could just say link to Tulip Time. I hit save and watch what happens. This is going to save that website over to that note. So now I'm going to go back over to my notes here, and you're going to see down at the bottom here, link to Tulip Time. And if I tap on this link, it opens it up in Safari. The last thing I want to show you is how we can share and collaborate with notes. What we're able to do, let's go back over to my notes app. What we're able to do is actually share this note or share any one of our notes with other people. And then we can both work on that note at the same time, collaborate on it. So let's say Beth and I were planning on going to Tulip Time and we want to take some notes. So what I'd like to do is have us work on the same note. To do that is just go to the share icon here. I open up the note. So this is a note I want to share. Tap on it. And then you're going to see it says send copy. I don't want to send a copy of this note. I want to collaborate. So what I do is I tap on send copy and look what I can do. Collaborate. When I tap on that, I invite Beth to collaborate on that. So I'm just going to go ahead and tap on that. And then I send it to her. She's going to get that text. And once she gets that text, she's going to accept that invitation. And she's going to have access to this note. So when I go back over my notes here, we can see that this is a shared note. That's why that icon is over on the left side. And I tap on it. I can also see it up here that it's a shared note. So Beth could be working on this and I could be working on this. Now, in addition to collaborating on that, you can also see what changes have been made. That's called activity. And you can also invite more people or just stop sharing. To do that, what you do is you go up to the little icon here. And From here, I'm able to see any activity. Now, there hasn't been any activity because I just created this, but this is where I'd be able to see what changes Beth has made to it. In addition to that, I'm also able to manage this. So when I tap on that, I can add more people to this note. We can have more than one person collaborate with us. I can also hide any alerts. Right now, I'm not going to get any alerts when she makes a change to it. If I turn that on, I'd get an alert. We also have share options here. With share options, I'm able to set who can access it, only people I invite, or anyone with a link. If you set it up to anyone with a link, as long as they have a browser, even if it's on a Windows machine, they're going to be able to access that note. So it's far less secure. You can also set up the permission. Can anyone make changes, or is it view only? So if I wanted Beth to be able to view it only, I could do that as well. And then adding people. Do I want Beth to be able to add people to this note, or do I want complete control over it and only I can add people to it? She'll still be able to access it, but only I can add people to it. So we have a lot of options when we collaborate on a note. And then we can stop sharing. I tap on that, and it's going to stop sharing that note. So those are some ways we can make our notes more useful. Instead of just having a title and body in there, what we're able to do is format the text, make it bold, make it italic. We can insert bulleted lists, create checklists, insert tables, add images, even scan to a note. And then we're also able to create links. We can link to a website, or we can even link to another note. And then if you want to share and collaborate on a note, you can do that as well. So as you can see, the Notes app is more than just a basic Notes app. We can do quite a bit with it. So that is how we can make our notes more useful with the Notes app. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You could subscribe to my channel. You can share it with your friends and family. In addition to that, you may want to check out danstutorials.com. Not only do I have more videos there, but I also have an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius, and I host classes and webinars on a regular basis. So how can you help support my videos? Well, it is a membership-based site. So when you become a member, what I'll do for you is take out all of the ads from the videos. You'll have access to that AI assistant. You have access to my classes and webinars. In addition to that, you're also helping out a small business. It is just me in a corner office. I'm not part of some large organization. So when you become a member, you are directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. Check out danstutorials.com for more information, and thanks for watching.